Many people know about famous painters like Da Vinci, Picasso, or Van Gogh. But did you know that the Philippines had one of their own major artists? Juan Luna was one of the nation's first widely recognized artists dating back to the late 1800s. With a background in sculpting and drawing, Luna is most well known for his paintings. Born in Bundok, Philippines, he studied art during college. He continued his artistic studies post-grad, where his skills were met with mixed reception. Some instructors praised his skills, while others lambasted him for being too wild with his technique. Luna continued studying art and traveled to Europe with his brother Manuel. There, Luna eventually became dissatisfied with the structure of his continued education. While working as an artist, he met Don Alejo Vera, who influenced him to pursue art outside of an academic institution. Working with Vera outside of school, Luna saw his skills grow much faster. He also gained exposure to the works of Renaissance painters and was able to participate in his first exhibition. Luna quickly gained popularity, exhibiting paintings such as the Battle of Lepanto, the Blood Compact, and the Death of Cleopatra that won him awards. He started getting commissioned by the likes of the Philippines government, numerous Spanish nobles, and even Spanish royalty. One of his most famous works is called Spolarium, commissioned by the Philippine government, that's still displayed there to this day. His artwork embodies elements of romanticism and influences from Rembrandt and Eugene Delacroix, along with conveying political tensions of the era. Luna was part of the Ilustrados, an educated and elite group of Filipino luminaries. Other members of Ilustrado included Marcelo H. Del Pilar, Mariano Ponce, his brother Antonio Luna, and maybe most notable, Jose Rizal. Thanks to his art, Luna was able to travel across Europe and Asia, showing off and selling his paintings. He was celebrated amongst art critics and his peers and won multiple awards for his work. However, the tail end of his career is mired in controversy. Controversy involving Luna murdering his wife in a fit of jealous rage, and other controversies including haunted paintings of said wife. But let's not get to that. Let's not discount his heinous and violent acts because they were terrible and far from picture perfect. But what we could agree is that his paintings were near perfect pictures.